Hello students, and welcome once again to my channel Learning Made Easy with Mandy. And today I am here with class 8 chapter 4 Bipin Chaudhary's Lapse of Memory. Students, in this chapter we will talk of Bipin Chaudhary, who is the protagonist of the story. Protagonist means the main lead, okay, around whom the whole story is moving. Okay, we will be talking about Bipin Chaudhary and what all incidents took place in the story. The story has lots of suspicious things. Okay, slowly when we will read the story and when the things are going to become quite clear. Okay, and then you will also find that this particular, what is the importance of this particular, the name of the chapter, that is Bipin Chaudhary's Lapse of Memory. Okay, children, even you must have heard or you must have seen movies and all also, in which some people, they lose their memory, like for some years, like doctors and all, they say that they report or they tell to the patient that now you do not remember your last 2 years or you do not remember your last 5 or 10 years. Okay, so in this way, usually in the movies and all these things are shown. Right, so in this chapter also we are going to experience something of like this sort. So let us begin with the chapter. This particular man, his name was Bipin Chaudhary. Okay, he was working in a firm and he was a very hard working man. So every Monday when he used to come back from his office, he used to stop at New Market. And there was a book stall where he used to go. There was a shop, Kali Charan's. And then he would go there and he would buy certain books. Around 5 books he would buy every Monday, because he loved reading a lot. Okay. And the books that he bought were of thriller stories, or you can say ghost stories. Okay. And he would buy those books and he would come back. And he would finish those books within 5-6 days, and again he would return, and then again he would buy another books. Okay, so this was how his daily, how the daily routine of this man was like. So one day, in the same way, when he went there on Monday, when he was coming back from the office, he dropped in at Kali Charan's. He was just searching for some books, that he heard of someone who called him by his name, Bipin Babu, and smiled also. Okay, and then Bipin Babu was like, I don't know who this man is and why is he smiling at me unnecessarily. You people also, whenever you go to some place and if someone looks at you and smiles, that means that person knows you, otherwise why will anybody look at you and smile? Isn't it? So the same thing came in the mind of Bipin Babu also, that I don't know this person, I don't know who he is and why is he smiling at me. And then he comes closer to Bipin Babu and sits with him and starts talking. So Bipin Babu says that I don't know you. You are saying you know me, you know my name, but I really don't know you. So he was surprised, and his name was Parimal Ghosh. So he was surprised. He was like, you don't know me. We were together for nearly a week's time at Ranchi in the year 1958. And you are saying that you don't know me. It was I who had planned all the things for you in Ranchi, wherever you had to go in Ranchi. So I was the one who used to make all the arrangements and all for you. And you are saying that you don't know me. So again he was surprised. Again Bipin Babu thought that why do I don't remember? Then he told him that no, in the year 1958, I had been to my friend's place, Haridas, who is living in Kanpur. And I don't think so that I had been to Ranchi. So again, that Parimal Ghosh said, no sir, just put some strain on your mind. I'm sure you will remember. I was the one who arranged car for you. You had to go to Hudru Falls. And I was the one who arranged the car and all for you, for Hudru Falls. And when you went there at Hudru Falls, you had fallen. okay, you fallen, there's an accident and you had fallen and you had hurt on your right knee. And it was a deep cut on your right knee. And you had a lot of pain over there on your right knee. And I was the one who went to the market and who provided you with iodine so that it can help you, okay, in healing. And then the next day you had to go to Netarhat, and for that also I had arranged a car for you so that you can go there easily. And when the next day the car came at your place, and then you refused, you said, no, I don't want to go, I will not be able to go because my knee is paining a lot. So he said that I had to manage each and everything for you, and you are saying that you don't know me. Okay, then he also tells that, okay, fine, I'll tell you some more things and then maybe that you remember. Like, it happens to us also, no? Whenever we forget something, then our friends or our parents and all, they tell us a few things related to it so that we memorize as to what that particular incident or event was. So in the same way, Parimal Ghosh also again started. He told him so many things. Like, he told him that you don't like staying in hotels. And because you don't like staying in hotels, and you stayed at your friend's place, okay, your friend who had been there to his sister, and his sister's house was there in Ranchi, and the name of your friend was Dinesh Mukherjee. He said that you stayed at Dinesh Mukherjee's sister's place because you don't like staying in hotels and you don't like the food also of hotels. So you said that the Bavarchi at Dinesh Mukherjee's place, he will make food for me, simple food for me, and I will eat that. Again, Bipin Babu thought that, why do I don't remember? He put a lot of strain on his head, but then he could not remember anything. But at the same time, he kept on looking into the books also, because he was there at the book place. He just wanted to buy some books for himself. So he just kept on looking at those books and all. And then he purchased 5 of the books and then he came out. So now what happened? And then while he was about to come out, this man Parimal Ghosh, he again knocked at his mind and he again told him that, sir, okay, fine, I'll tell you some more things. Always, whenever you go for some trips, you always carry a bag of books with you. Again, he was shocked that how come that he knows this, that I carry books along with me. And then he told him that, sir, when you had met me in the year 1958, you had told me that you had lost your wife 10 years ago. You had also told me that you don't have any children, you live all alone, all by yourself. And the next thing that you had told me was that your brother, who was insane, who had some mental problem, and he also died in a mental asylum. Sir, all these things were told by you to me in Ranchi. Again, he was surprised that how do I not remember all these things? Because these are very intimate things. These are very, very personal things which I usually don't share with anybody. How can I share these things with this man? And this man, whatever this man is telling, that is correct. Okay, now he was shocked. Means he thought that, is it something wrong going with my mind? Okay, now he started thinking of all those. He started recalling that, whether have I really lost my memory? What is wrong with me? So he just came out, he paid the bill of the books and he just comes out. Okay. And then he tells his driver that, okay, driver, let us go towards the Ganga banks. So the driver took him to the Ganga banks. And you know, whenever you go to any river bank, how do you feel? You feel very peaceful. You feel very good at heart. Okay, all your tensions and worries are gone. But with Bipin Chand, it did not happen. Now when he came into the Ganga Ghat, there also he kept on thinking that how come an incident which is just of 6 or 7 years back, okay, and how is it possible that I have forgotten that incident which took place 6 or 7 years before? Am I losing my memory? Is there any problem in my mind? Okay, now he was restless. So he started thinking of all those things. He thought that, then again, he was quite optimistic. He thought, no, maybe there is something wrong. I am doing lots of work. I work so hard. A very responsible post is given to me in the firm. I work day and night. Okay, and but then I don't forget anything. I remember everything. So how is it possible? This man is lying. But still, somewhere in his mind, this thing was striking that how do I don't remember that I had been to Ranchi in the year 1958? That thing kept on knocking him all the time. Okay, then he thought, then now negative things started coming into his mind. What if I lose my job? What will happen? What will people say if I'll start doing wrong things? Okay, what will happen if ultimately I'll have to be admitted in a mental asylum? Because his brother was also in a mental asylum and he passed away. So he did not want to go to a mental asylum. And he also remembered that Parimal Ghosh also told him that when you were in Ranchi and I asked you that would you like to go to mental asylum? Would you like to pay a visit over there? But then you refused. So he was very confused. He was like, what should I do and what not should I do? How should I remember? Whom should I ask? So he thought that, okay, fine. If Parimal Ghosh was talking about Dinesh Mukherjee, then my friend Dinesh Mukherjee must be knowing that I had visited Ranchi and that too also I stayed in his house. So he thought if I'll ask my friend, then he might make joke of me. He might say, oh, you are growing old, okay. And that's why you have turned eccentric and now you are asking me where did you go 6-7 years back. So again he was confused. Then he thought, okay, let me ask Haridas Bagchi, because he remembered one thing, that in the year 1958 he had been to Kanpur in the month of October and he had celebrated the puja. He went there and he enjoyed his puja holidays with Haridas Bagchi. So he thought, let me give a call to him. And then he again remembers that no, Haridas has gone along with his wife to Japan. Okay, and a few weeks back he had left for Japan. So nothing was coming to his mind. He was so confused and that he told his driver, okay, fine, you drop me at my place. So he comes to his place, okay, in the evening he comes back and then he goes to his room and then he takes an ice pack and he puts it on his head and sits for some time. Okay, because the things were going in his mind like anything, that how do I don't remember? I'm so good at memory, my friends and everybody, Bipin, your memory is too good. And now I'm not remembering all these things. Okay, so he was a bit tired of thinking of all these things. Okay, and then he slept. Okay, somehow he just slept. So in the morning, he thought that when I go to my office, I'll call Dinesh Mukherjee. So he thought that, okay, because if I will be face to face with Dinesh Mukherjee, he'll make fun of me. So it's better that I give him a phone call. So he just rang his number once the work was over. Whatever work he was doing in the office, it was over. He just dialed his number and he called him. Okay. And then he asked Dinesh Mukherjee that, you just tell me, Dinesh, were you there in Calcutta the whole year? He did not ask it directly, that where was I, were we both there in Ranchi? He did not ask this. This shows that Bipin Chaudhary was a very smart person. So he asked Dinesh Mukherjee in a very different way, okay? So he asked him that where were you there the whole year in Calcutta? So Dinesh Mukherjee said that let me check my diary. He used to write diary. So he said, wait, let me check my diary and I'll tell you where all I went. So he told him that yes, I was out twice in the year 1958. I had been twice outside. So he asked me, where did he go? So I said that once I had been in the month of February, I had been to a wedding, okay, in Krishnanagar, which is a very nearby place to Calcutta. And the second, he said that you also must be knowing about the second visit. He said, I also must be known. He said, yes, we both were together in Ranchi. So he was like shocked like anything. Then even he is saying, Dinesh Mukherjee is also saying the same thing. Then he thought that definitely something is wrong in my mind. He was so shocked and surprised. Okay, it was his body went all chill when Dinesh Mukherjee told him the same thing. So he told in the evening once the work and all was over. So after completing all his work, because he was so shocked when even Dinesh Mukherjee also gave a clean chit that yes, you were there with me in 1958 in Ranchi. So now he was like, what should I do? What not should I do? He was in a fix. So he just winds up all the work in the office and he leaves for his home. Okay, he calls the driver and he leaves for his home. And now when he goes back home, he was not in a good mood and in a not in a good condition also to talk or to do any other thing. So he takes a novel in his hand, and there was a thriller story, and he takes that in his hand and he starts reading it. So for some time he just forgets about that particular incident, because as I told you, he loved reading books a lot. So he was engrossed so much in that thriller book that he forgot about each and everything. Okay, what all Dinesh Mukherjee said, what all Parimal Ghosh said, what all things were going on in his life for the past 2 days. Okay, so after some time, while he was engrossed so much in reading the book, what happened? There was a doorbell rings, and the servant, he comes to Bipin Babu's room and he tells him that one of your friends, Chunni Lal, has come to see you. So Bipin Babu thought that I don't want to meet this friend of mine, because Chunni Lal was his school days friend. Okay, and he had lost his job. And so he was after, every time he used to come to Bipin Babu and he used to ask him that please do something for me. Could you please find some job for me so that I can also survive? I'm starving. I don't have money also to lead my life. And also every now and then he would come and he would urge in front of his friend. And Bipin Babu never paid any kind of heed. Okay, he just took it very lightly. Okay, he would not, he was not interested in listening to what Chunni Lal's problems are. Should you do like this with your friends? Do you also do like this, children, with your friend? When any of your friend asks you that, okay, I'm in a trouble, so what is your, what you should do? You should help your friend, isn't it? At your best, whatever you can do for your friend, at least you should do that much, right? This is called a gentleman's gesture. But as far as Bipin Babu was concerned, Bipin Chaudhary did not pay any heed. He was not bothered whatever Chunni Lal said to him, although Chunni Lal was in a big trouble. So then he told his servant that, okay, fine, you just tell him that I'm not well and I don't want to meet him, and tell him to go. So when the servant goes there and tells Chunni Lal that my master Bipin Chaudhary, he doesn't want to meet you, so it's better that you leave. So as Chunni Lal just stood up in order to leave the house, so Bipin Chaudhary, he just ran down the stairs. He thought, let me ask Chunni Lal whether I had been in the year 1958 to Ranchi or not. He must be knowing. Okay. So he just goes there and he sits there, and very straightforward, he did not say hello, hi to him. He did not ask why you have come, how is your life going on, nothing, nothing at all. Very straightforward, he did not beat about the bushes at all, and very straightforwardly he just asked him that, do you know, had I been to Ranchi in the year 1958 during Puja holidays? So Chunni Lal said that, are you joking? He said, no, I'm not joking. Tell me the truth. He said, of course you had been to Ranchi in the year 1958, and I was the one who did your railway ticketing done for you, booking and all done for you. And you are asking me, what is wrong with you? Have you gone mad or what? So again, Bipin Babu, he said, yes, I went along with you. I dropped you at the railway station. And one of the fans in your bogie was also not working. Okay, your coach was not working. And so I had told the electrician also to do that thing for you. So he said, is it so? So, but he could not remember anything. He said that I don't remember. Then very jokingly, because they were good friends, so he just asked him that, okay, fine, Bipin, just tell me which job I was doing lastly, which was my last job. So Bipin immediately tells him that you were working in a travel agency. So he said, thank God that you remember that I was working in a travel agency. And you don't remember an incident which took place 6 to 7 years back. What is wrong with you, Bipin? Are you losing your memory or what? Now Bipin was on his heels. He thought that, what should I do? And immediately, as soon as Chunnilal went, he just calls his doctor, physician, Dr. Chanda, to immediately come to his place. So when Dr. Chanda comes to his place, he listens to his problem. So he tells him that, you see, it is not my job. I don't deal with patients who have memory loss and all, okay? But still, I will give you some medicine that will help you to relax. You will have a good sleep and have it for a few days, and I hope you will feel better, okay? But as far as this problem is concerned, you better consult some psychiatrist, right? Now again the same thing was coming in the mind of Bipin Chaudhary, because his brother had also turned insane, and he was also there in the mental asylum where he had died. So all those things were coming in his mind, coming and going all the time in his mind. So he thought, what should I do, what not should I do? But still he had that medicine and he had a good sleep, and the next morning he was quite fresh. And when in the morning, when he went to the office, so he got all his work and all done. And then he thought that, let me go to that place Ranchi and let me see if I can go there, if I can remind. Okay, in the movies and all, children also, you must have seen that doctors, what do they tell? They tell, okay, fine, if the same kind of sequence is repeated again, then maybe that this person regains his memory. So is thinking of the same thing. And the advice of Dr. Chanda, he said that, okay, fine, let me go to Ranchi. So he gets the booking and all done for Ranchi and he goes there. Now when he goes there to Ranchi, what did he see? He saw that all the marketplaces, the railway station, okay, there was one Muradabadi hills, every place was very new to him. He had never ever seen all those things. So he was like asked, like, why is it that people, everybody is saying the same thing, that I had been to Ranchi, but now when I look at all the places in Ranchi, I don't think that I have been here. Very confused he was. Okay, so he just booked a car and he went to Kudru Falls. He said, let me go to each and every place, whatever was told to me by Parimal Ghosh, who met him in the at that Kali Charan's bookshop. So he goes to Kudru Falls also, and when he goes there, he looks there, he says, no, I have not been here ever. So thinking of all these things, there was a lot of pressure in his mind that he became unconscious and he falls. And then there was one, there were some tourists over there, they were from Gujarat. So they picked him up and they put him in the car and they dropped him back to his hotel. And then when he came to consciousness, he again remembered that that Kudru Fall also is the place where I have never been. How come they are all saying like this? And then he returns back home. Now when he returns back home to the railway station, and then again the daily courses of his life began. So he gets a letter. Okay, he was so unwell that one day he gets a letter. Okay, and on that letter it was written, urgent and confidential. So the servant brings that letter to Bipin Babu, that, sir, this letter is for you, somebody, it has just come, could you please see this? So he just opens that letter and he reads. Okay, in that it was written, dear Bipin, and I am Chunnilal here, your friend, and my I am because Chunnilal was a writer. He used to write novels and all. So he said that one of my stories which I have written, and one of the maybe some film producing people, maybe he said that my book has been liked by one of the publishers, and most probably or maybe if luck favors me, then my book might get published and all my problems will be solved. Now I will never come to you and ask for any kind of a financial. help. And down there it was written Chunnilal. Okay. And then he had also written the same thing that although you were the one who did not listen to me at all, I was your friend, you should have helped me a lot, but then you did not help me. So I being a writer, because I am a writer in my instinct, okay, so I just thought of playing a prank with you. This was a prank being played by me and it was my plot. I had asked everybody to say all these things to you so that you are misguided and misled, and so that you also feel some trouble, okay, in order to put you in trouble, in order to give you a kind of a punishment, that you should always listen to your friends when they are in trouble, you should try and help them when they are in a problem. So, and you did not help me, so this was a kind of a punishment for the same, and down there it was written Chunnilal. So now Vipin Babu, he just remembers that Parimal Ghosh, Dinesh Mukherjee and everybody who all were involved in it were actually making fool of him. They were actually trying to trouble him. Although in reality he had never been to Ranchi in the year 1958 during Puja holidays. He had actually been to Haridas Bagchi in Kanpur during Puja holidays in the year 1958. So in this way, the whole story was, the things were all clear in the mind of Bipin Babu. Okay, all the things were clear in his mind. And he really felt sorry for his behavior towards his friend. So this was the story of Bipin Chaudhary, who had lost his memory. So in the end, we come to know that everything was fraudulent. It was a prank being played by friends. Usually friends do like this. It was a prank which was being played by a friend. So what do we learn from this chapter, students? We learn one thing, that we should never try and hurt anybody. And especially to those who are your friends, who are your schoolmates, who was your friend since your school days. And you and Bipin Babu did not pay any heed towards him. He did not talk to him properly. He did not listen to his problems. He did not try to help his friend in some way or the other. He could have helped because he was working in a good firm, and he could have helped him in getting a small job, at least so that he does not die. He does not starve all those years. Okay. So this is what we have learned. Do not harm anyone. Love people around you. Care about them. Okay? Care about those people who are around you, who have importance in your life. Right? So this is the message that we have learned from this particular story. I hope you have understood, and you have also subscribed my channel. If you haven't, then do subscribe my channel and do share the link with your friends also. And do not forget to press the bell icon so that you keep on getting the notifications of my upcoming videos.